You know, it's almost springtime, isn't it? I thought last week that spring had already come because the weather was so beautiful, but then we had a day like yesterday and this morning, and it's just cold again. But I always love it when it's almost springtime. You know why? Because one of my favorite activities, flying a kite. How many of you have ever flown a kite before? Kites are pretty fun, aren't they? You put it on the end of that string, you let it go up as high as it can possibly go, and then you just stand there and you watch that thing soar. You know, it seems so simple, doesn't it? Just... You don't like to go on an airplane with Papa? Okay, well, this is a kite. It'll go a little bit lower than an airplane. We'll fly one together. I'll make sure you get to fly one. It's not quite like an airplane. But it's a kite. But you know, it seems so simple that you put a kite on the end of a string and then you let it go and it would be so much fun. But it is, isn't it? What is it, though? The reason why I'm telling you about kites is what is it that keeps that kite up in the air? The wind, yeah. I got a question for you. Have you guys ever seen the wind? No. You have? Are you sure? Are you sure? Yeah? Well, we're talking about the wind now. We'll get back to airplanes later, okay? So some of you say that you've seen the wind. Some of you go, no, I've never seen the wind. So we have a mixed audience. So we're going to have to solve this dilemma, all right? Now, I propose to you that you never actually have seen the wind, but rather you have seen the effects of the wind, right? Here's what I mean. You don't really see the wind, but you can certainly hear it, can't you? Hear that wind going? Whenever that noise comes on, you know air's coming from somewhere, right? It's like an air conditioner. Well, not only can you hear the wind, but you also what?
Feel it.
You feel it. You guys feel that? You can feel it. You don't feel it, Nick? Well, here, let me help you out there. You feel it, yeah. Well, it's a small fan. I mean, I'm not going to blow you guys over. But yeah. You know, you feel the wind. You feel it coming. Do I dry your eyes out, Sydney? I'm sorry. You feel the effects of the wind. You can feel that air coming on you. You know, that's what wind does. If you have a bunch of paper, like your homework that I know you're so studious to do, if you've got all your homework stacked up on your desk and somebody opens up the door or they open up a window, what happens to all of those papers? They fly all over the place. So the wind, I'll say this, you never really see the wind, but you know the wind's there because you see the effects of the wind, right? Well, what I want to talk to you today from the Bible comes from Acts chapter 2. And this is a very important time in church history because Jesus had already ascended up into heaven. He had gone to be with his Father, and they were left behind to start the church, to start spreading the good news, start spreading the gospel. But Jesus, the man, was no longer here on earth, was he? He had gone up into heaven. So they're kind of in this place where, well, we know Jesus was here. We could see him, we could feel him, we could touch him, we could hear him, all of these things. So we knew he was there. But he's promised that he's going to send something else, and we won't be able to see it. It'll kind of be like the wind. And so in Acts chapter 2, verse 4, this is what it says. It says, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit. Let me back up to verse 2. That's the one that I wanted to read. And suddenly there came from heaven a sound. What do you think the sound was like?
Wind.
A mighty rushing wind came down and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. This is the day of Pentecost. This is when the Holy Spirit shows up. And how does the scripture say that he comes? Like a wind. So that means that we need to apply what we just learned about wind to the Holy Spirit, right? We can't see him, but we can certainly see the effects of him, can't we? How can we see the effects of him? Well, do you think we can hear him? Oh, you better believe we can hear him. Sometimes we don't hear him speak audibly like I'm speaking now, but we can certainly hear him talking in our hearts. Sometimes we do hear him speak to us audibly. Sometimes we hear him speak to us through his word. Sometimes we hear him speak to us through other people. But yeah, we can certainly hear him. How about, do we feel his presence? Oh, we certainly do. We feel his presence. Whenever we're sitting there and things are bad and we've had a really bad day, or maybe we've lost somebody that we loved, a grandma or grandpa, or maybe we've lost our dog or our cat and we're just sad, but we have this peace. That's when we know the Holy Spirit is with us. We can certainly feel him. And we see him working in others, don't we? We can look at somebody and go, you know what? They're doing God's will because the Holy Spirit is working through them. So, you know, you can't see the Holy Spirit, but I promise you guys, he's there. And the reason why is because you can hear him, you can feel him, and you can see him. So you see the effects of the Holy Spirit. Let me pray with you, and then you can go to Kidstown. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for your Holy Spirit, that it came like a mighty rushing wind. And that though we can't see the mighty rushing wind, we can certainly see its effects. We can see things move. We can see things change. We can hear that wind. And we just thank you that we can do that with the Spirit as well, Father. So I just ask that you would just blow like a mighty wind over these children and over their families, and that you would bless them. And so, Father God, we just give you glory and praise today in Jesus' most precious name. Amen. Thank you, guys. Sydney, stay away from planes in Kidstown, okay?
That love will make you crazy. Well, is it true? Well, that's no rumor. Look at the crazy things that love made Jesus do. Well, the friends he chose were thought to be outrageous. And you could even find him touching the contagious, yeah.
Yeah, you could.
And the craziest is how he chose to save us, save us. He gave his life away, then he had to go and say, got to love the same way that I love you. Love like crazy, yeah, 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 yeah.
Like crazy.
You gotta love like crazy.
Yeah.